Let's discuss what all do we write in profit and loss account. See, all the indirect expenses and all the indirect incomes have to be written in profit and loss account, so we get a net profit related to it. It is actually made on year end. So see what is written here, profit and loss account for the year ending 31st March and the date. Okay, the year should be mentioned here, say 2015. Same sides like a ledger, debit particulars amount, credit particulars amount. First of all, the balance which we got from trading account has to be brought forward by gross profit brought forward and the amount needs to be mentioned here. Okay. What all things need to be recorded on the debit side? Think of any indirect expense and you have to jot it down here. Say, let's start with salaries. Two salaries. One important point in the question, if it is given as salaries and wages, then record it in the P&L account. But if it is given as wages and salaries, wages is written over here, wages and salaries, then put it in the trading account. Don't put it in the P&L account. Why do you do so? See, wages generally relate to direct expenses and whatever is more material is written first. So if it is wages and salaries, direct expenses, then put it in the trading account. If it is salaries and wages, then salaries is mostly an indirect expense. So salaries and wages needs to be written in the profit and loss account. Remember, this is a confusing point, but a small point to be remembered. Okay. What all office expenses can you think of? Two, office rent, stationery, printing expenses, printing and stationery, okay, office insurance or any material insurance, to communication expenses, be it telephone expenses, electricity expenses, electricity of the office premises, so the electricity bill needs to be paid here, to electricity. Expenses. Okay, all the legal expenses, to legal expenses. See, there may be many expenses which will go over a year, the benefit of which will be received over a year. Only the expenses of which you reap benefit, you incur them to reap benefit. So if it is within 12 months, then put it in the P&L account. If the benefit is more than 12 months, we have to exactly read what the question is. But if it is of an enduring nature, then check if it has to be put in the balance sheet. All these expenses, electricity expenses, telephone, insurance, rent, stationery, printing, these all expenses are expenses that out of when we incur it, we get the benefit within 12 months. Okay, these are revenue in nature. So the legal expenses, the accounting expenses, or the audit fees, the auditing expenses, it has the auditing expenses have to be given to a chartered accountant. So this is again revenue in nature, to repairs and maintenance, to keep the asset into working condition. Okay, I am not upgrading my asset, but to keep the asset into workable condition, I have to incur some repairs, some maintenance expenses. So those expenses have to be put in. It is actually a very elaborated list. You have to apply your mind at that time and check what is the nature of expense, whether it is revenue or whether it is capital, and whether it is direct expense or whether it is indirect expense, and accordingly you have to act. Okay, advertisement expense, again an indirect expense. Carriage outward. See, if it is written carriage inward, something is coming inside the factory, so it is an expense related to purchase, so if it has to be put in trading account. But when it is carriage outward, something related to sales, so it is an indirect expense and you have to put it in the P&L account debit side, to carriage outward. Okay, sometimes our debtors don't turn up, they prove bad and we don't recover from them, so this is also an indirect expense to bad debts. Sometimes we do a provision for bad and doubtful debts, to provision. For doubtful debts. Okay, sometime for sales we say pay some selling commission to the salesman. It is expenses incurred for sales, and indirect expense has to be written in profit and loss account. So to selling commission. What else? Bank charges, interest on loans, again indirect expenses. Bank charges, interest on loans, all indirect expenses. Okay, sometimes we allow some cash discount to customers for prompt payment. That discount also needs to be recorded in books. It is an indirect expense. So to discount allowed to customers. Okay, now any entertainment expenses, any postage and telegram expenses, traveling expenses, traveling expenses. Also have to be debited to profit and loss account, all indirect expenses. Okay, so now some kind of abnormal losses also need to be recorded here. What are those losses? Loss by fire, loss by theft, these all losses are also indirect in nature. Record them in P&L account. To loss by fire, theft, etc. Okay, now what is loss on sale of any investment? This also has to be recorded here, and then any loss on sale of fixed assets. To loss on sale of fixed assets has to be recorded here. Now continuing with the income part, what all indirect incomes do I need to record in a profit and loss account? Discount received. I have received any discount. So by discount received, discount received is my income. When discount allowed is expense, discount received is my income, has to be written here. Commission received. Amount portion to be written here. What I have received. Okay. By rent received. By dividend received on shares. If the firm owes some dividend, some shares, and it has received dividend, so that will be put in here. Dividend received. Okay, and we'll talk later about any abnormal gains, whether they have to be recorded here or not while doing the practical questions. So for now, summing up, what we have to do is gross profit, which has to be taken from the trading account, and all the incomes have to be added, then all the expenses have to be added. Now whatever is the sum here, generally whatever is the sum in the credit side is more, because generally we have a net profit. So this net profit, actually we have one more slide, so the sum here less the total of debit side, whatever is the balance is written as to net profit transferred to capital account. Okay, and we add, if it is a profit, we add it to our capital. If it is a loss, we deduct it from our capital, and the total is plugged in here. So this is an overview of your profit and loss account. Always for the debit side use to, and for the credit side use by, as you do in your cash book also. See, just keep on judging what are the indirect expenses, and then will the benefit be taken within 12 months. If both are yes, indirect expense yes, benefit will be taken within 12 months yes. If for both your answer is yes, you can blindly put it in your profit and loss account. It will give more clarity when we do the practical questions.